maybe a little bit of a background on Silicon Valley Bank. As Karen said, we bank about 4,000 venture-backed companies. A little more context, we have about 13,000 total clients, and in the U.S., we bank about 50% of any company in the U.S. that has received a round of venture capital financing, and we bank more than 50% of all the venture capital firms in the U.S. And to Karen's point, we do have offices all over the U.S., 26 offices, anywhere where you would think there would be a high-tech center, an innovation sector center in the U.S. So to answer your question specifically, I would say first you have to break down the market into what I would call three segments. And I thought you did at the beginning this morning, did a good job of breaking it down in two segments. I would add a third. So if you take Main Street America, the startups, the businesses, the dry cleaners, and all the other traditional businesses, that's one segment. Another segment is the innovation sector. But I think you should break down that sector one more way. You should stratify that in two parts. One is growth, and then extremely high growth companies. Just real quick stat on venture-backed companies. So venture capitalists have invested in venture capital-backed companies. It's maybe $200 to $250 billion over the history. Those companies have created 11% of the private sector jobs and 21% of the overall GDP of the economy. So for a very small amount of capital, these high growth, super high growth companies have had a huge impact on the overall economy. Now we're focused on that sector and the second sector, but I'm gonna spend more time focusing on the ultra top companies. So their access to credit over the last 10 years has really been very consistent. Since we have such a high market share, we work in providing credit to these companies, and even in 2008, 2009,